Okay, this is the video about a loop within a loop, but it is not the previous video which was about a loop within a loop. This is really the video about a loop within a loop that you imagined it was going to be. We're going to talk about nested loops here. So first of all, when do we need a nested loop? Well, let's first look at something we did a little bit earlier. Over here, we had a program that we wrote when we were learning about while and for loops, which drew this grid pattern on the screen. We drew a bunch of lines horizontally, and we drew a bunch of lines vertically. We used a while loop to do it horizontally, a for loop to do it vertically, just to demonstrate those two different kinds of loops. So that's one thing, and it gives us this pattern over here. Essentially, we have this pattern over here. But what if, instead of these lines going across and lines coming down, we actually want these to be rectangles, and rectangles that we could fill in. Perhaps each one is going to get a random brightness value between 0 and 255. How are we going to do that? Well, let's first see why the structure we have over there, which is over there, I guess, doesn't work. OK, so first thing first, let's actually just make both of these for loops, because I think that'll be easier to look at. So now we have a for loop, int x equals 0. X is less than width, and then x equals x, x equals x plus 20. And now we have both these loops, and look what we've got. We've got two for loops, one for the horizontal lines, one for the vertical lines. We have our grid pattern. But remember, we need to fill in those rectangles. So we need to make each element that we're drawing rectangle, 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 rectangle up, and rectangles down, all over in a grid pattern on the screen. So this shouldn't be too hard, right? All we have to do is change this to rectangle. The rectangle is at x, 0, and its width is going to be, 20, and its height will be 20. And this one will be 0, y, and its width will be 20, and its height will be 20, and it's also a rectangle, and we don't. Let's just do a fill now of 127, just so we give it, we'll worry about random later. Oh, we're close, but we have a loop to draw rectangles across and a loop to draw rectangles down. How do we get the ones in the middle? Well, let's think about that. What are we really saying here? We're actually, we could be saying one thing, right? We have this idea of columns, which we're thinking of as X, and rows, which we're thinking of as y. These are the rows, these are the columns. We are saying for every column, draw a rectangle. We also are saying for every row, draw a rectangle. Well, that's what we did. For every column, draw a rectangle. For every row, draw a rectangle. Well, actually, what we want to say is, for every row, draw all the columns of rectangles. For row 0, draw all the rectangles across the column. For row 1, draw all the rectangles. What does that mean exactly? We actually want to say not two separate for statements. We want to say this. For every row, for every y value, for every column, draw a rectangle, right? We're in row 0, draw all the rectangles. We're in row 1, draw all the rectangles. So this is what we're talking about, a nested loop. We're going to do a loop each time through every, we're going to loop through all the rows, and for each row, we're going to loop through all the columns. So how does that work? What if I just took this loop and put it right inside here? And what if I drew the rectangle then at x, y? Let's look at this. Now we have this grid pattern. For every row, for every y, loop all the way through. We have a loop within a loop. This might sound confusing. It might be causing you some confusion. You might need to just take a break, lie down for a few minutes, look at this again, have a snack, look at it again. But if you really think about it, if you really can get yourself to walk through this code, what's happening? Well, first, y is equal to 0. Then what happens? Okay, well, then x is equal to 0. Then x is equal to 20. Then x is equal to 40. Then x is equal to 60, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. What happens next? Okay, we're done with that. Well, we're in the outside loop. Y is equal to 20. Then what's next? Well, X is equal to 0 and X is equal to 20. So for each Y that we're looping, there's another loop that happens inside. And we can see this because the X loop is inside the outer Y loop. So I encourage you to sort of like walk yourself through this on your own. How do we make them all random color? Well, easy. I can just take this fill right here and say, hey, fill random 255. And there we go. Now we have this pattern where each one of those gets a random color. This is essentially a like a checkerboard or chessboard. I should have had an exercise prepared for you. So if you're looking for an exercise, well, there's lots of interesting things you could try. For example, what if you were to do this nested loop, but instead of having every color be random, have the color actually be organized on some along some principle? Like, for example, what if the colors were all darkest in the center and lightest in the outside? I think you need a clue for this. There is a function in processing called distance. The distance function takes four arguments. Where are we? Oh, I didn't start the timer, so who knows how long I've been going. But it takes four arguments. It takes an x, y of one point and an x, y in another point, and it gives you the distance. So you could use, you could actually even color these according to how far away they are from the mouse. Kind of an interesting problem. Why don't you give that a try? And I might try to, if I ever re-record this video, a note to self, I might try to think of a better exercise that has to do with nested loops. I'm sure one of you will have a suggestion. Somebody will and will send it to me. Okay, so I think this actually concludes all of the videos, the initial videos at least, about loops. Probably fill in some more and add some more as we as they sort of come up or people ask questions or there's other things. Okay, so that's the end of this one. Thank you.